if COVID-19 has taught us anything, and I hope it has taught us many lessons, but one lesson is that the care of people, care of our seniors especially, cannot be about profit. It cannot be about profit, and this is something that our government needs to understand. I also want to thank all the family councils and all the advocates across this province who have been fighting for our seniors, who have been fighting for the care of our elders and our grandparents and parents. And it's so important to really emphasize the point that there, by the time it was July, about 96% of the deaths, the 96% of the lives that we lost during COVID by July, were people over the age of 60. That says something. That what I'm hearing from the other side makes me feel like some of the government members were sleeping, Mr. Speaker. It is astounding that we are in this House providing lip service at times when people are dying. People are literally dying because of neglect, because of lack of care. And these people are our parents, our grandparents, the people who went to war for us, people who actually saved all of this province, people who built the foundation of this province, Mr. Speaker. We have to make sure that we do the best. And clearly, we have governments after governments who have forgotten that. And we have to make sure that we have an independent advocate who will represent the needs of our seniors. And this is why we need to pass this bill now.